First step in this problem, to make life a little bit easier, is to factor off a negative 1. So I get 6x to the fifth minus 5x to the fourth minus 14x to the third plus 8x squared plus 8x minus 3. Now we are going to search for the factors, and one of the things we're going to use is that if a is a root of the polynomial, a place where the graph crosses or touches the x-axis, f of a is 0, also means that x minus a is a factor. So if a is a root, x minus a is a factor. So I'm going to just notice, first of all, that x equal minus 1 is a root. The graph touches the axis at minus 1. The fact that it just touches the axis tells me that the root is of multiplicity 2. Or in other words, x minus negative 1, or x plus 1, squared is going to be one of the factors. Similarly, from this fact, x minus 1 is one of the factors because x equals 1 is a root. We now have to search out these other two roots, and they're not quite as easy to tell. What we can do, however, is divide these two polynomials, x plus 1 squared and x minus 1, into this larger polynomial using either synthetic division or long division if we choose, and we get the following. X plus 1 quantity squared, x minus 1, and 6x squared minus 11x plus 3. So again, this quadratic comes from dividing these two into this. Well, now the rest of the factorization is pretty straightforward. X plus 1 quantity squared, x minus 1, 3x minus 1, and 2x minus 3. If we notice that since 3x minus 1 is a factor, x equal 1/3 is a root, and x equal 3/2 is a root from that other factor. So this is the complete factorization. And from the factorization, you can also see the roots of the polynomial.